Hey guys, welcome back to Top Tech Reviews, and today we're going to be going over some overlay websites that you can go to and get free overlays, or have another alternative option instead of using OBS, using another program that would have provided overlays for animated overlays or static overlays. So with nothing further ado, let's hop into it. Okay, so to start out, you want to open your Google and go to this URL that I'm going to have in the description. I'm going to have all three in the description. This is a website that has paid overlays and free downloads. So if you just go to free downloads, you can see different overlays that they have made. Under this tab, there's a handful. These are all static. There is no animation. This is actually a graphic package. So this would be getting all the Twitch panels, the BRB screen, stream starting screen, plus the overlay and the alert boxes for Streamlabs or whatever alert system that you use. So let's just pick this guy for example. So we're just gonna go down to that, open that up, and then here you can obviously zoom in and view everything. So what you would do now is go to download now. And then it's just gonna have you type in your email, bam, throw my email in there. And now when this downloads, it's going to be in a zip file, so you're going to have to unzip it. Obviously, it shows your payment status, complete, free purchase, date you got it. And then you're just going to click on that, and it should start downloading a little pop-up down here below. Bam. So it did bring up a thing, so the Air Force thing would be in here, and all you would do is go to right-click, extract all, and then set a specific location that you'd want it. So in this case, we're just going to leave it in downloads. If I can find it. Okay, we're just going to send it to... Oh, okay. It updated. So you can see here, these are all the about, PNG, the Twitter, the PG rules. These are all the things that I got from that website, the panels. And then basically what you do is obviously go over there, do add image, and then wherever you save these images on your computer, you would just click add that image from that location, and then there you go, you got that graphic. And this works for overlays too. This isn't just for panel graphics, as I said. And like I said, I'll have a link in the description below. Next people we're gonna check out is NerdArtEye. You may have heard these guys. These guys also have paid and free content. Some of them are animated, some of them are not. They have many. This website specifically doesn't just have overlays. This has a bunch of stuff, and you guys can check that out obviously with the link in the description. So we're just gonna be like background vid, for example. Here's one that I use for streaming. It's free. There's actually another one too down here. So we'll switch it up and we'll just click on this guy. Bam. So this one you can either set a price or just be like, boom, zero, add to cart. And then it's in your cart. And what you do then is just go up here to the cart thingy, check out. And then obviously here you put all your information and then place order, and then it would just give you another download link or start automatically downloading once you have filled the information out. And then after that, obviously it's either going to be in a zip file or just the file itself, and you can find that in your downloads if you're using Windows or wherever you have your browser download set to. Just go in that folder, and then it's able to be used after it's extracted from the zip, if it's in the zip, or it be able to use as soon as possible. So I'll have a link if you guys want to check out all the resources these guys have in the description below as well. And the next thing I'm going to show you guys is a program that I've just recently installed and started using. Aside from OBS, which I'm actually going to show you on how to find login information or download information. So this is Streamlabs, and if you don't know what that is, it's basically a tab that shows you the alert boxes and stuff like that, basically the widgets you can have in your stream. And basically what you do here is set up stuff, customize it, whatnot for your stream, and shows you your recent activities such as follows, donations, and whatnot. Okay, so what you would do here is go to, where is it? There is a ting. Streamlabs OBS, and you're going to click the download button, and that will send a EXE file down in the downloads. What you would do then is install this program with a new, like, it's pretty straightforward. Just install it. You shouldn't have any issues. If your computer says, oh, this might be a virus, ignore it. It's not. I promise you, it's from the website. I've been downloaded it myself. And then once that's installed and ready to be used, what you can do is launch the program if it hasn't already launched itself. So right now I'm going to launch it. This thing will check for automatic updates, and it's basically just like OBS but has a different concept to it. So let me go to window capture again. Okay, and there's the program. So as you can tell, this thing's a little bit set up a little bit differently. Right now we're in the editor panel, and you can see I have an animated overlay. What you can do here is go to the library, and they have thousands of free overlays they can use that are static and animated. So let's say, and you can tell that they're animated because it says animated at the bottom, and they're completely free for use. It shows you what's included, the animation that it does, and overlay the animation, and you can customize everything in the editor for like the text and stuff. And this actually should be already pre-set up by itself if you have the StreamLabels files installed and on your computer. This program will automatically find those files and install, and I shouldn't say install them, but implement the text of your recent follower and whatnot. But if for some reason it doesn't, you can obviously just do that by using the text tool in OBS. So and not really feeling that one. Let's find, you know what, screw it. We're gonna click install overlay, and then go back to listing, go back to editor, I believe, if it will let me. And then you can see the overlay has been installed. They're all there. Don't know why my webcam isn't there, which is odd. Unless this doesn't really necessarily have to have a webcam. And then you have your intermissions, which you can add your text box over here, and then your webcam and new donations and whatnot. And then on this tab, let's say if you have a bunch, because as of right now I have a bunch of different Streamlabs. Like this I use for CSGO. This obviously Overwatch. I use it Overwatch overlay. I use it for Overwatch. There's a whole bunch of them. You can look at them. And if you just want to use something from the other websites, you're more than able to, because all you got to do is literally just be like, bam. And now, if you have stuff in OBS, the regular OBS, and you just installed this, it will give you the option to transfer stuff over. So if you want that set up, you can keep that set up, but use this program. You can do that without having to go through the whole jizz and jazz of going in, setting everything up again. This program automatically transfers all that scene over to this one. But basically what you do is just click add. If you want to start from scratch, select what you want. Obviously shows your scene, whatnot, followers and whatnot. So it's a pretty cool program. Not really sure what program uses less CPU, honestly. You can probably compare them if you did a benchmark. If you guys even want me to, I can do a benchmark video for you guys to compare what program works best. But if you guys have any questions about what program to use, just leave them down in the comment sections. I'm more than happy to answer any of your questions. I have all the links to these programs and websites in the description as well for you guys, so you can click them and check them out. Hope this video helps for people looking for overlays, and I'll see you guys next video.